حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وأطهر المرسلين، شفيع المذنبين وحبيب رب العالمين محمد صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة. In the name of Allah, the compassionate, the most merciful. All praise is due to Allah, and may His peace and blessings be upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Indeed, the best of speech is the book of Allah, and the best of guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We bear witness that no one is worthy of worship but Allah, and we bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is indeed His final messenger. Ya ahbab Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, من المعلوم بالضرورة في ديننا أن دينا لا تصحبه أخلاق هو دين لا قيمة له. كل دين لا يصحب بأخلاق هو دين لا قيمة له. It is an established fact, as far as the teachings of Islam are concerned, that any aspect of religiosity that does not impact the character of the individual, that act of religiosity is of very little value. Especially in our deen, especially in the teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he said that his main mission, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ, that I was sent so that I may perfect for people the best of characters, the best of manners. So to us, we Muslims, the way that we express our deen, our religiosity, by what kind of people are we becoming as a result of being Muslims. And subhanAllah, the way that our akhlaq, our manners, our character, what kind of people that we are tested by events that are around us. And subhanAllah, especially nowadays, financially speaking, people losing their jobs, people getting laid off, people not able to pay the rent, people's health care is in jeopardy, people's mortgages are difficult to cope with nowadays. And as a result, questions come up. What kind of a person are you becoming because of the financial difficulties that you are facing? And let us face it, we are facing some very difficult financial times. Very common nowadays it becomes that people come into the masjid and they come in and say, it's an eviction notice. I have been told to vacate because I can't pay rent.
People come into the masjid with their medical bill saying, look, I can no longer afford to pay my insurance, I need help. We had one brother who came to the masjid and he said, look, I registered my daughter for school, but I cannot buy her the books. He said, my daughter will not go to this semester to school because I do not have $250 extra to pay for the books of my daughter. These are difficult times for a good number of people out there. But the question is, these difficult times, what kind of people are we becoming as a result of these difficult times? Because subhanAllah, it is in these difficult times that the true nature of us comes out. Who are you? And that's why the Quran tells us as to how the human beings respond to these types of difficulties. فَأَمَّا الْإِنسَانُ إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَقَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقَهُ يَقُولُ رَبِّي أَهَانًا. It said that, and amongst people are men or women whom when Allah chooses to constrain as far as the sustenance that is given to them, they get all disappointed and they are all miserable and they say, رَبِّي أَهَانًا, my Lord has disgraced me. وَإِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَأَكْرَمَهُ وَنَعَّمَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَكْرَمًا. And the same test happens on the other hand, when you have Allah and you have plenty, the man rejoices and says, my Lord is indeed pleased with me. So that we start thinking that we don't have much, it's because Allah does not like us. And if we have a lot, it is because Allah likes us. And that is not the case. And subhanAllah, interestingly speaking, just looking into how people react to this, when they don't have the cash in their hands, when they don't have the money, what kind of people do they become? What kind of people do we become as a result of us not having money? And here are some of the negative choices that people have made so far. There is a rise in the consumption of alcohol. People start drinking. They cannot cope with the level of stress that is being placed on them. So what do? They start drinking. But how does drinking alleviate your problems? How does drinking bring you more money? It does not. And maybe yes, it does relax you, but it is a false sense of relaxation. So for us to go through that route, that is a very unwise, poor decision to be made. We don't want to do this. Yes, things are difficult, but you don't take that route. People come in and they are so unbelievably depressed to the point that they are no longer interested in living anymore. Times are so difficult, they tell you, I don't have any money, I feel worthless, I feel I am like a no one. And now they're not even interested in living anymore. As a result, some people, what they do is, they don't have a job, they are really stressed out because of this. What do? They go home and they take it out on their families. Nowadays, domestic violence is in the rise as well. A man beats his wife because he doesn't have a job. How is this her fault? How does beating your wife make you get a job or a raise or a promotion or any of that stuff? It does not. Or people look for shortcuts. They start gambling. Because now they think that, you know what, this is so difficult. I can't make it like that. I need some quick money. Let us gamble. Let's do this. Let's do that. And it does not work, my brothers and sisters. It does not work out that way. But the bigger question that we want to know is, who are you becoming as a result of you not having money? See, nowadays, we live in a culture, in times where a person's worth is determined by how much money you have. They say in Europe, it's all about what you wear. Are you wearing the Armani suit? Are you wearing the Gap? What kind of a brand name are you wearing? So now your worth is determined by what you wear. They say in the East Coast in New York, it's about where you dine. What restaurants have you gone to? And when you speak, can you speak about the different plates and dishes that you have had? And then it's in California, it's all about what you drive. Let the Lexus speak for you. I don't want no Lexus speaking for me, I want to speak for myself. A car does not make a man makes his own self. But this is what we've been taught, that somehow material things gives us values. Material things is what makes us who we are, and that is not the case. So these are difficult times, but as a result, what kind of a person are we becoming? And the worst of all is when we stop being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ha inshallah, كيف الأحوال كيف عامل زي الزفت والزفت أحسن كيف الحال أبدا ما كلين هوا. You ask people, how are you doing? And you hear the worst types of expressions about how terrible things are and how bad they are. And in the process, we stop being grateful. Where we no longer thankful. We are so busy thinking about what we do not have that we forget to enjoy what we have. We literally forget to enjoy what we have. We are very ungrateful. And this is what's happening now. And that is why it said that one time, Umar ibn al-Khattab is going around the Kaaba, and he hears this Bedouin making a strange dua. Allahumma ij'alni min al-aqalliyin. Allahumma ij'alni min al-aqalliyin. Oh Allah, makes me, oh Allah, make me amongst the few or the minority. And Umar ibn al-Khattab thinks that this dua is so vague. And he holds the man, he says, wayhak, waman al-aqalliyun? He said, woe to you, who is this minority that you're speaking about, that you want to be with? فَنَظَرَ إِلَيْهِ الْأَعْرَابِيُّ وَقَالَ يَا عُمَرْ أَمَا قَرَأْتَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَقُولُ وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورِ. He said, Umar, have you not read the book of Allah? For in it Allah says, an only small group amongst my servants are truly those who are grateful to Allah. So he's praying and he's saying, oh Allah, make me amongst those who are grateful. But you know what we understand gratefulness to be? When you move to the new house, alhamdulillah. But what about the house that you had? No alhamdulillah for that one? When you buy the new car, oh alhamdulillah. Well, what about before? No alhamdulillah from before? When you get the... We think that we are supposed to be grateful to Allah only when big things happen to us. Very similar to the students. Before they take their exam, they raise their hands. Oh Allah, please make this exam easy. And they haven't studied before the exam. Yet they come into the exam and they beg Allah for their help. But the minute they're done, and what happens afterwards? Allah is not remembered. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us to be grateful. But to be grateful, the fact that we are living is a sign that is, that deserves to be on our part, to be grateful for. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam كان يقول إذا أوى إلى فراشه. Subhanallah, اسمع آخر كلمات يتفوه بها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا ذهب إلى النوم. يقول الحمد لله الذي أطعمنا وسقانا وآوانا وكفانا فكم ممن لا مؤوي له ولا كاف. صلوا على رسول الله. Please move forward, inshallah, to make room for those who are coming in. Listen to this. The Prophet, peace be upon him, the very last words that he would speak when he goes at night, what does he say? What does he pray for? What does he say? Some of the most beautiful, optimistic, positive words. He gets up there, Alhamdulillah, الذي أطعمنا. All praises due to Allah, who has given us something to eat for the day. وسقانا, and something to drink. وَآوَانَا, and he gave us a shelter to be under. وَكَفَانَا, and he has provided us family to give us love and care. And then the Prophet ﷺ said and reminds us, فَكَمْ يَعْنِي يَبِيتْ هَذِهِ اللَّيْلَةِ فَكَمْ مِمَّنْ لَا مُؤْوِيَ لَهُ وَلَا كَافْ. For how many people are going to spend the night with no shelter and nobody to take or to look after them? What happens when he wakes up in the morning? من أصبح معافا في بدنه عنده قوت يومه آمنا في سربه فقد حيزت له الدنيا بحذافيرها. صلوا على رسول الله. Said whosoever wakes up in the morning, physically they are okay. In their heart, they are in peace. Guaranteed that they have some sustenance for the day. It is as if this whole world was presented to them on a golden plate. Not talking about something big, it's just these basic elements. If you are grateful for them, subhanAllah, your life becomes much easier. Gratefulness, gratitude, my brothers and sisters, is a sign of optimism. When you are grateful, there's good energy that comes from you, especially around your kids. Some people, they are with their kids and all they talk about is negativity. All they speak about how bad things are. They speak to their wives about how difficult things are. Yes, that may be the case, but the point is, why don't you look for what is going on good and you speak about that? يَا أَحْبَابَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مِنْ عَجَائِبِ مَا رُوِيَ عَنْ عِيسَى عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ أَنَّهُ كَانَ يَسِيرُ مَعَ أَصْحَابِهِ. It was said that one time Jesus was walking with his disciples and they see a dead dog and everybody grabs their nose and they turn away about how ugly and how disgusting and how bad it smells. Isa alayhi salam looks at it and what does he say? Subhanallah, ma abyada asnanahu. Said, all praises due to Allah, this dead dog has got some beautiful white teeth. So some of the disciples, they looked at him and they said, Ya Nabi Allah, innahu kalbun mayyit. Said, O Messenger of Allah, it is just a dead dog. Isa alayhi salam then says, Ra'aytum aswa'a ma fihi wa takallamtum, wa ra'aytu ahsana ma fihi wa takallam. Said, you people saw the worst in it, and you spoke, and I saw the best in it, and I spoke. Not denying anything, but the point is, where do you want to be fixated at? What do you want to see? It is all at your disposal, but what do you choose to see? So at this time, brothers and sisters, we need to be grateful. We need to be given shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for things that we take for granted. For things that, you know, if you have a family, alhamdulillah. If you have health, alhamdulillah. If you are conscious and not dead, alhamdulillah. If you're here today, alhamdulillah. Let that be our motto in life. That we are people, no matter how bad things are, we can genuinely and sincerely say, alhamdulillah. Because it is, alhamdulillah. And that is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would speak about who are the best type of people. الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَحْسَنُوا اسْتَبْشَرُوا وَإِذَا ابْتُلُوا صَبَرُوا وَإِذَا أُنِعِمَ عَلَيْهِمْ يعني كأنهم شكروا أو كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. When he was speaking about the five characteristics of people, the Prophet, peace be upon him, would speak about who they are. They are those who rejoice when they do something good. إِذَا أَحْسَنُوا اسْتَبْشَرُوا وَإِذَا أَسَاءُوا اسْتَغْفَرُوا. And when they sin, they make poor choices, they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when they are given, they're always grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. تَأَمَّلْ مَعِي نُوح عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ ذُرِّيَّةَ مَنْ حَمَلْنَا مَعَ نُوحٍ إِنَّهُ كَانَ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. إِبْرَاهِيمَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ يَصِفُهُ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى اجْتَبَاهُ شَاكِرًا لِأَنْعُمِهِ. Allah speaks about Nuh. And the very first thing that we know about Nuh is that he was a grateful servant. Allah speaks about Ibrahim, he was a devout man or a devout individual. But then also Allah reminds us that what made him so special is that he was a person that was always grateful. شَاكِرْ لِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. Yes, brothers and sisters, times are difficult, but now is not the time to be depressed. Now is not the time to be stingy. Now is not the time to be, you know, going through anxiety and worry, but rather now is the time of being practical, but at the same time also we want to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As far as practicality, when they talk about why do people get into the mess that they have gotten in, they say that the number one reason is when we buy things we don't need. Please, if you don't need it, you don't have to have it. Don't buy it. It's as simple as this. وَقَدِيمًا قَالُوا حَارِبِ الْغَلَاءَ بِالْإِسْتِغْنَاءَ. حَارِبِ الْغَلَاءَ بِالْإِسْتِغْنَاءَ وَإِذَا غَلَى عَلَيَّ شَيْءٌ تَرَكْتُهُ فَأَرْخَصُ مَا يَكُونُ إِذَا غَلَى. هذا لطيف. قل وَإِذَا غَلَى عَلَيَّ شَيْءٌ تَرَكْتُهُ فَأَرْخَصُ مَا يَكُونُ إِذَا غَلَى. He said that when things get too expensive for me to buy, I don't buy them, and this is when they're least expensive because you're not buying them. So the point is, if you don't need it, do not buy it. And then the second reason that they mention is, people do not budget. We have to start to learn how to budget and see the need in budgeting, because this is one way of coping, practically coping with what is going on around us. But besides all of this, then the last one is really sad, is people want to take shortcuts in making quick money. Shortcuts in making quick money, and then we end up losing. Nothing wrong with wanting more, but also it has to be something that is calculated. But by the end of the day, in these difficult times, what we want to do is we want to be more grateful. Do not forget what you have, because that you are so worried about what you do not have that you forget to enjoy what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على رسوله المصطفى وعلى من بآثاره اكتفى. Brothers and sisters, you are probably aware of what is going on in India, in Mumbai. We've been watching this for the last almost 48 hours, where it is said that a good number of innocent souls are either lost, killed, or they are injured. And as you know, what happens when there is such a heinous act takes place? The first thing is people always think of, now what did the Muslims do this time? We Muslims pray, oh Allah, please, not one of us again. Because this is given such a terrible image. And it's not about image, but it's about the innocent souls that are lost. People are going about doing their business, be they tourists, be they locals, be they native, be they foreigners. People are where they are because where they want to be, and that is their right. Nobody goes anywhere and expects to be harmed because of the place that they are in. They get ambushed, they get attacked, and somebody comes in and washed when it is done in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because people look into this and immediately everybody starts saying, well, who might be? Within the Muslims, see, we know that it's a Muslim. But what we're worried about is we want to be as exact as possible. Which Muslims are they? Because the fact that they're Muslims is almost a given. We're not saying that it is or it is not. But the fact that when something bad happens, for people to immediately think, oh, it's the Muslims again. Wallahi, we have young kids at the masjid. Again, they ask. They asking of us Muslims, elders, and saying, again, Muslims are doing it. This is embarrassing. This is embarrassing. You know, the innocent souls that are lost, but also this idea of what do people think about us at this point. In the hadith, it was mentioned that in Medina, the Prophet ﷺ knew about the hypocrites. And everybody knew who they were. And everybody knew what terrible things that they were doing. So some people will come to the Prophet ﷺ and say, Ya Rasulullah, نقتلهم, let's kill them. And then what does the Prophet ﷺ say? أَتُرِيدُ أَن يَتَحَدَّثَ النَّاسِ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا يَقْتُلُ أَصْحَابَهُ. He said, do you want people to talk and say that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is killing his companions, he kills his people? He said, the fact that it may potentially be a terrible public relation or something that is bad for people to talk about, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, I am not going to do this. We can't do that. After one of the battles, the Prophet ﷺ is distributing war booty, and this rigid man comes and says, Ya Muhammad, i'dil baynana. He said, oh Muhammad, be just. The Prophet ﷺ looked at him and he said, Wayhak, وَمَن يَعْدِلْ إِن لَمْ أَعْدِلْ أَنَا. He said, woe to you, who is to be just if the messenger of Allah himself is not just? And somebody gets up and volunteers and says, Prophet of Allah, should I kill him? And the Prophet ﷺ said, so that people will say that Muhammad ﷺ kill people who oppose him, or Muhammad ﷺ kill his own companions. Something like that is not accepted. The fact that people can mention it, the Prophet ﷺ did not find to be something that was good. And nowadays you look into this and you say, La ilaha illallah, here goes again. They've done it again. Nowhere in our deen, absolutely nowhere in our deen, it said that if you are wronged, you go and you wrong somebody else. They are as innocent as you are. Why do you think that it's bad when it happens to you, but somehow you give yourself a license that you can do it to some other innocent soul? Said who? Said who? How were these people involved in whatever it was? How were they involved? So when we look into this, is we have to have this conviction that what Islam says is one thing, what Muslims do is totally different. Islam is one thing, but the Muslims and what they do may or may not be a reflection of the teachings of Islam. And such a thing, if it was the Muslims that have done it, it has nothing to do with the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we don't say this because that's what we want the media to hear. We say this because wallahi, this is our genuine, sincere conviction that there is no way on earth that Allah allows the killing of the innocent souls the same way that it has been happening right now. We just don't accept that. And there is no ifs, there is no, but they do this somewhere else. They do what they do, but we don't do that. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, he was brought two heads of patriarchs. They had a fight with Rome, and then they had beheaded people, and they brought the two heads to him. And he said, what is this? And they said, حَتَّى نُعْلِمَكَ أَنَّا قَدْ قَتَلْنَاهُمْ. He said, so that we tell you that we have killed them. Abu Bakr looked at them and he said, إِنَّمَا كَانَ يَكْفِ الرَّسُولِ. He said that it would have sufficed that to send a messenger to let me know that, you know, such and such person are dead, part of the battle. And then they said to him, وَلَكِنَّهُمْ يَفْعَلُونَ هَذَا بِنَا. But this is what they do to us, they tell Abu Bakr. He looked at him and he said, أَفَبِهِمْ نَقْتَدِي. Since when do we follow them? We follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We do not follow that. Even if they do it, it does not say that you go and you do something like this. You look into this and you cannot help and say, Ya Allah, please. Please. This is getting sickening. It is getting to the point where some Muslims come in and they say, you know what? This is just too much. Very little I want to have with Islam and the Muslims. If we are going to judge Islam on the actions and the basis of other Muslims, we're going to be very disappointed. We will be disappointed. So let us see the beauty of Islam for what it is, not for what the people do with it. And please do keep in your prayers the families of the people that died. May Allah give them lots and lots of sabr, Ya Rabbil Alameen. The Muslims and the non-Muslims amongst them. And for those who are injured, may Allah give them a speedy recovery. Because of what has happened to them. And when we pray like this, we are sincere, inshallah, about our prayers. Inshallah, tomorrow will be the first day of the Hijjah. You know that Eid, inshallah, will be on the 10th. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ma min ayyamin al-amal as-salih fihinna ahabbu ila Allah min 'ashr dhil-Hijjah." There are no days where good deeds are most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the first 10 days of the Hijjah. This is an opportunity. So please, inshallah, let us seize the opportunity of being alive during the first 10 days of the Hijjah. And the good deeds will include the recitation of the Quran, you know, keeping in good relationship with your relatives, the fasting during the days, especially the day of Arafah, the giving in charity and what have you. So please, inshallah, do seize that opportunity for the first 10 days of the Hijjah. And also please do remember, inshallah, that part of this Eid is that we have to make a sacrifice. The sacrifice we can make locally, and we can also delegate somebody else to do it somewhere else where there is more need for it. And I believe that there are brothers outside who are going to be collecting your sacrifice to be slaughtered for the people in Palestine or any other place that is of your choice. So please do see them outside. And it is perfectly fine that you don't have to do your udhiyah yourself. Do it where it is needed. Do it where it is needed more, inshallah. Also keep in your prayers those who are going for Hajj. And pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them a safe journey. That they go there and their deeds are accepted. And inshallah, on their way back also, they have a safe journey as well in the process. Also, please keep in your prayers those who are having difficult times, be it their health issues, be it the financial issues, maybe they don't have a job. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open the gates for them.
and those who have passed away, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all their souls, Ya Rabbil Alameen. اللهم يا رب إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم يا رب فرج همنا وهم المهمومين ونفس كربنا وكرب المكروبين واقض الدين عنا وعن المدينين اللهم يا رب ارحم موتانا واشف مرضانا وفك أسرانا وعاف مبتلانا واختم بالصالحات الباقيات آجالنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم يا رب اجعلنا من عبادك الشاكرين اللهم يا رب اجعلنا من عبادك الشاكرين يا رب اجعلنا من عبادك الشاكرين اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك اللهم يا رب تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر الله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقم الصلاة